Hello, Ashoka fellow, for introducing me to you. And I just discovered that term when somebody was talking to us, saying one fellow, Ashoka fellow, introducing the other. For a great surprise, I've traveled quite a lot, but this is my first visit to Nepal. And it's very easy for anybody sitting in India to know that Nepal is a very beautiful country. You don't need to really be intelligent, nor do you need to be here to actually discover that. What I have discovered over the last 24 or 36 hours is that not only is this country very beautiful, but it has a large number of people who actually are very beautiful human beings in the way they have evolved. And I got introduced to that spirit yesterday while having an interaction, personal interaction with a lot of those people who possibly will get awarded today. So I would like to thank those who invited me here. Santoshi, who actually called me and kept calling me till the time I changed my schedule to be here. And Change Fusion Nepal, Luna Shrestha, NBI and Surya Nepal, who made it possible for me to come here. I wanted to thank each one of you who is here and who I will be able to speak to through this stage where I stand. I know it's we are actually discussing something which is very difficult to explain. The number of times I've been asked, what is the difference between entrepreneurship and social entrepreneurship? And what is the difference between a business that is operating in general versus a social entrepreneur? Clearly tells me that our focus is actually on a completely wrong idea. I don't think so the word social entrepreneurship is important. Actually, it has no meaning whatsoever. We are here in a country that actually will benefit if we, all of us, actually behave and work honestly toward the purpose we set ourselves to. And the world at some point of time would recognize whether you have been an entrepreneur or a social entrepreneur or you are a corporate house. So it's not really important to spend too much time discussing what is it that actually distinguishes an entrepreneur from a social entrepreneur. It's meaningless actually in some sense. I personally do not really enjoy the term social entrepreneur because it creates far more confusion than it solves. And I have always believed in that. I actually started a fund which is called by various people in various terminologies. I'll give you some. It's a social venture capital fund, it's a rural venture capital fund, it's an impact investment fund, and these kind of nomenclatures confound and confuse the normal human being who wants to start a small business to bring about a change, possibly first in his life, and through the act of bringing about change in his life to the lives of those fellow people who actually cannot set up an enterprise. So really, let's stick to that. Let's do not spend too much time trying to dissect and figure out what social entrepreneurs mean. But I actually still wanted to give you an example of a business that would possibly qualify as a social business.